Hello everybody and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Yakuza 0. In the last episode, we went with Oda to the squatter's place and dealt with him, and we also learnt how to real estate. There was an entire new sub-mode that has now opened up to us, and in this episode, as promised, it's time to do some side questing. Also, forgot to mention, you may have noticed that the office looks a little bit different, and I got that from the shrine. You look familiar. Can I help you, sir? Oh, it's you! Oh, I'm having some unpleasant memories. Oh, it's you! Didn't I see you at Queen Ayusama's dungeon? Oh, right. With Ayu the Dominatrix. What was your name? Ayusama calls me masochistic man, and pig, and slave, and... I see. Thank you for your help at the playroom the other day. Help? Since that day, Ayusama has reached a whole new level as a dominatrix. Perhaps it's thanks to you. That's great. There are no words to express my humblest gratitude to you, so instead of words, I would like to thank you with deeds. Deeds? The word on the street is that you're running a business. I thought perhaps I'd be able to use my skills from my day job as a consultant to serve help you. Whoa, you're a consultant? I never would have guessed. But sure, I'd love to get your help. Heh heh. The more straight-laced you are on the streets, the more likely you are to be in the freak in the sheets. I'm gonna take it you know from experience. The masochistic man has joined your team as an advisor. So, I actually knew about this, but certain people that you help in sub-stories and friendships will actually come and help you with your side activity. It's actually a thing that was used in Ishin. It wasn't used as much, but it was still used occasionally with a different side mode, which was the Battle Dungeon, I think it was called. And you'd get the character card and they would... you would use the card to activate abilities. It was really neat, and this game's version of that. So, you have good skills in the pleasure quarter, which makes sense, and your pay is 2 million yen. This is wonderful. I'm looking forward to serving you. Please make me squeal like a little piggy. Squee! Heart. Sure. You do realize you're not even trying to hide your free flag right now, right? I guess it doesn't matter. Hey man, to each his own. So, looks like we got our first helper from a previous side quest, and looks like we got one more right here. Hey buddy, how's it going?
Ah, Kiryu-san! How have you been?
Hey, Kikuchi, how's your police work going?
Thanks to you, Kiryu-san! I can handle police work other than routine stop and searches now.
Good. I'm glad.
But since I only did stop and searches for the longest time, I'm hopelessly out of shape. In fact, I've been messing up a lot. A police officer ought to be much stronger.
Sure. True. Sure? How did I get shot? Whatever. True. I'm sure there are times when you have to physically intervene to break up fights or capture suspects by force.
Yes. I need to get back in shape somehow, but I haven't found the right opportunity to do it yet.
Getting in shape, huh? I know. Our company is hiring security staff. Are you interested in helping us?
Hmm? That would give me a chance to get in shape. It would be moonlighting, though, and I can't do that.
You're right. Then I won't pay you. How about it if I buy you meals instead?
Hmm. I wonder if that's okay. I'm pretty sure that's well outside the rules, too. Oh, what the hell? I owe you big time, Kiryu-san. Please let me help you.
Officer Kikuchi has joined your team as security staff. Safety influence. So you're pretty bad at first, but then your middle is actually pretty damn good. And your problem solving is really high. Great. Thanks for your help.
Yes, I'll get stronger and become a great police officer, just like my old partner.
Man, seen so many familiar faces. It's bringing a tear to my eye. Okay, not really, but you get the idea. It's really nice to see epilogues, I guess you'd call them, to certain sub-stories that we've done in the past. And speaking of sub-stories we've done in the past, you may remember that ages ago, there was a sub-story that we started with a Yankee-looking fellow. What's going on? This is a rough-looking crowd.
Oh, I'm so freaking stoked, man! A rare street show by the Yokomichi Silvers! Too right, those guys are rock and roll gods! Look at this bitchin' crowd, they drew all these punks without any ads or nothing! Crazy Kyo and the Kokomichi Silvers fucking rule! And keep your pants on, but I heard Kokomichi Silvers are gonna hold a Q&A panel too! No effing way! They're famous for never saying a word and letting their music do the talking! I wonder what the hell they'll talk about!
Sounds like some band's doing an event here. Must be popular with the local punks. There's the guy. Is that? Hey buddy, how you doing? It's been a while.
Oh my gosh, oh my gosh. Oh, look at these people, holy cow. Oh, what are we gonna do?
Oi.
Hey, you.
Yikes! Gee whiz, pal, I nearly peed my... what are you doing chuffing around behind me, you ugly knob?
Yeah, sorry. I thought I should apologize for bumping into you earlier.
Oi! Who? Oh, you're that man! No, I should be apologizing for my own carelessness. I mean, whatever! Piss off!
Sure.
Well, this is awkward.
Cool.
Wait a second. Do you possibly be unaware of who I am?
Yeah.
Are you asking if we met before we bumped into each other? If we did, I don't recognize you.
Yeah. Oh, wait a second then. So, you really don't know who I am? Willikers, what a relief.
Huh?
I'm sorry. I was rude not to introduce myself. Name's Kyo. Kusanagi? Is that you?
Yeah, probably not.
But my stage name is Crazy Kyo. I'm the vocalist in the band.
God damn it.
I don't know why, the voice is just making me crack up for some reason.
It's trying to sound Yankee and sort of American, but it just sort of comes out like the dancer's voice from the Majima training session. Ugh.
Let me guess, the Yokomichi Silvers? The same band those young punks are excited to see? Aren't you guys some kind of legendary Yankee band?
Yes, that's us. We're doing a street show here later.
Oh, sorry to bother you before your show. Good luck.
Whoa, where the hell do you think you're going, old man? Wait, please, sir, don't go. Maybe you can save me.
Save you?
Nani?
What? Are you even hardcore in the slightest?
No. As a joke, we tried dressing old punk at a show to our shot. We got pretty popular with the Yankee crowd. But now we have to keep up the charade full time. Over time, we gained a fan base of wannabe punks, and the Yokomichi Silvers became heroes to the rebellious youth of Japan. The whole style is called Yankee now.
There's more to running a band than I thought. So, what did you mean by me saving you?
I want you to teach me how to be a hardcore hooligan.
Nani?
Teach you? To be a Yankee?
Yes. You see, for today's event, we also have to do a live panel, a meet and greet for the fans. Every member of the Yokomichi Silvers, myself included, are law-abiding choir boys. We never even shoplifted. If we were to talk in front of a real Yankee, they'd realize that we're phonies.
Fake punks, eh? Now that you mention it, the way you talk doesn't match how you dress at all.
Right. So, if we spoke to our fans, we'd lose all of our credibility and popularity in an instant. Or worse, what if they want revenge on us for fooling them?
Okay. But do you have to do this panel thing? Why don't you just skip it?
I don't want to do it either. But our agency says we need to hone our speaking skills if we want to stay popular. They're making us do this. We've been avoiding every situation where we might have to talk instead of just performing, but now...
Got it. So you want me to teach you how to behave like a Yankee so you can talk like one. But why me?
Why? Well, that would be because you're my idea of what... You're my idea of what a hooligan should be. That confident demeanor. Your razor-sharp glare. The barbed wire attitude that says, touch me and get cut. And yet, you also exude a sense of kindness. A guy who extends a helping hand to the weak. The hooligan with a heart of gold. That's my ideal Yankee.
Well, yeah, I am Yakuza, kind of.
You can teach us so we don't have to blow our cover. More than that, I think you can give us a Yankee wisdom that will propel the Yokomichi Silvers to new heights of hooliganism.
Jesus Christ, buddy, you're giving me way too much credit.
Please, if we lose this chance, the Yokomichi Silvers may have to break up. Please teach me how to carry myself like a true Yankee.
Oh my god. As always, just go for it. Okay. Ben, okay, Ben. I'm not sure how useful I can be, but I'll try.
Really? Oh, thank you so much! Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't catch your name.
It's Kiryu.
Okie dokie, Kiryu-san. Give me just a second, please. I'll go get the others. Sorry to keep you waiting, Kiryu-san.
So, this is your crew?
This is our drummer, Sleazy Tarashi.
Why is that so hard to say? Whatever.
Hey there, I'm Tarashi. My stage name is Sleazy, but I have no experience with the ladies. Never even seen a boob. And this is our bassist, Bad Boy Aku.
I'm Aku. I'll be caring for the elders.
And this is Kiryu-san, who's going to impart the ways of the true Yankee-style hooliganism onto us.
Please teach us, Kiryu-san.
Huh. You guys are so polite and proper. I'm starting to wonder if there's anything I could do for you.
Oh no, please don't say that. We're all pretty good guys at heart, so please help us.
In your case, being pretty good guys is the problem. But I did agree to do this, so somehow, we have to turn you guys into hard-edged punks.
Oh, yes, please!
Huh. How can I show you guys how to be tougher, though?
Well, maybe you could come up with an opening remark for a little old me.
Your opening remark?
Yes, I want to kick off our panel with authority. Being hooligans, we shouldn't come across as weak or hesitant. Please, Kiryu-san. I need a zinger of an opening line to set the tone.
Huh. Start your engines is pretty good. Yeah, let's go with that. Why not open with start your engines?
Start your engines? Oh, like a racing term!
Right. The Yankee movement is inspired by Western greasers. They love their wheels.
So true! That does go with the Yankee lifestyle, so I should follow with something like, you get my pistols pumping, don't you think?
Heh, that's good. It wouldn't hurt to throw in something like, ram it into overdrive either.
Right. I didn't know about that one. I'm so glad we got your advice, Kiryu-san.
Kiryu-san, question.
Hmm? What is it?
Well, the agency told me we need to tell our fans about how I spend my days off when I'm not rehearsing or performing.
Your days off, huh? Makes sense that fans would want to know their heroes from... It would make sense that fans would want to know how their heroes live from day to day. Tarashi, how would you spend a day off?
Well, I make a habit of getting up bright and early so I can make some pancakes. Oh, after breakfast, I take my darling puppy Chibi-chan to the park for our mid-morning stroll. And then, we have lunch at a sheet cafe and rest our feet. On our way home, we do a little window shopping. After that, I binge on the dramas I've got on my VCR until it's bedtime. The sad thing is, that doesn't even sound like a bad day to me.
You just described a typical girl's day.
I'm sorry, Kiryu, but it actually doesn't sound that bad to me either.
Sorry, that really made you sound like a fashionable young woman. I was so surprised I got intense.
I'm so scared.
Oh no, Kiryu-san. You shouldn't shout like that. You made sleazy Tereshi cry. That's a bit much, don't you think?
Oh dear.
Should I say sorry?
Yeah. No, wait, you should say sorry. God damn it! Yeah, my bad, Tereshi.
It's alright. I was just startled. I wasn't expecting it, is all. So, how would I spend a day off?
Yeah, right. One thing's clear, you can't tell the fans how you really spend your free time.
No, I guess not, but then, what should I say? What would I be doing instead?
Fighting all day's pretty Yankee, right? And that's pretty hardcore, right? I fight all day. I beat up random punks on the street for money. On your days off, you spend your time fighting from dawn till dusk.
Fighting? I really don't get it, but who do hooligans fight? Do Yankee have sworn enemies or something?
It's not about having enemies. Yankee are always ready and willing to fight. If two punks locked eyes, a fight is on. That's how it is on the mean streets of Kamurocho. And just so you know, fist fighting is considered the most hardcore and cool.
Jeepers, what a brutal community. I can't take my dog out for a walk in that war zone.
Yeah.
Hold on. The dogs that punks keep The dogs that punks keep tend to fiercely loyal and thirsty for blood. They're often trusty partners in a street fight.
Is that right? I can't picture my delicate Chibi-chan engaging in a kerfuffle like that. Boy, am I glad we could hit up you up for advice, Kiryu-san. You're the perfect hooligan role model.
Kiryu-san?
Hmm?
Hmm? Oh, you're bad boy Aku, right? What's the matter? What do I say? Hmm? Aku? You didn't get a topic like Tereshi? Nope. The agency told him to wing it. He's free to talk about whatever. Even though he's practically mute. Bad boy Aku even has a backstory. Locked up in juvenile reformatories from birth, bad boy Aku crushed packs of punts before he even finished preschool. Huh. Your agency's trying to fit a square peg in a round hole. Aku's a man of few words with a crazy backstory. What should he talk about to make him sound hardcore? You know what? Stay silent. Don't you think it'd be better just to stay quiet? Huh? Stay silent during the panel? Wouldn't a discussion without any talking be a disaster?
Yeah.
Nope. Aku was told he's free to talk about whatever he wants. That means he's also free to not talk at all. That's true, but it would be worse if he were to say the wrong things and wreck his image. From Aku's backstory, I think he would seem more hardcore if he kept his mouth shut. When you put it like that, it does make total sense. Okay, we'll do that. Bad boy Aku stays speechless during his part. Sure, Aku. Are you good with that? Okay. Alright, now we'll go over how you'll run through this whole panel discussion. Yes, please!
Yo, Kamichi Silvers! We're almost ready for you!
Oh, it's time? I mean... Fine! Grrrr!
Sorry! I mean, you can come on when you're ready!
I'll be watching from the audience. Yes, please watch us. We're going to hit this hardcore Yankee thing out of the park!
We're going to kick ass and stuff!
Mm-hmm. God, I hope this goes well.
Here they are! Put your hands together for, the Yokomichi Silvers!
Ooh! Crazy Kyo-san! Bad boy Aku over here! Whoa! Check out Crazy Kyo-san's original ESP guitar! Smokin' Rat style! The man's got the Yankee look nailed! Wow. They are popular. When they're not talking, they do look like real greasers. Something wet, hot, rock and roll after school! Tereshi Aku, hit it, boys! Damn it, I was kind of hoping to see a little bit of a performance. Oh well.
That concludes today's performance by the Yokomichi Silvers.
Just listening to their songs, I can see why Yankee kids across Japan look up to Crazy Kyo's band.
Now, we would like to move on to our special meet and greet panel discussion with the band members.
Whoa, no way, no way! Crazy Kyo-san, that should go talk to us. That's totally mental! I can't fucking wait to hear bad boy Aku's voice.
Here's where it gets real. They better pull this off.
Yo, Grease Hounds! We're the Komichi Silvers, start your engines! Yeah! Crazy Kyo-san! Cool your jets, bro! But I gotta hand it to Crazy Kyo-san. He knows how to rev us up and kick us into top gear! He's totally fucking ace! Thanks for coming and rocking out to our tunes. We love you all, you romantic rebels. You punks get my pistons pumping. Right here, under the hood. I love you like my turbo drive.
Oh. Good, these fans are eating it up. Going with racing terms paid off.
Awesome, thank you, Crazy Kyo-san. Next, we would like to hear from Sleazy Tarashi-san and Bad Boy Aku-san as well. First up, Sleazy Tarashi-san, here's a question we got from a fan. How do you usually spend your days off?
Me? If I get a day off, I spend it fighting mostly. Sleazy Tarashi-san's a beast, man! Fighting's like exercise to him, too wicked for words! Oh shit, I would pay to get my ass kicked by Tarashi-san, even just once.
Just so you know, I don't allow nothing but going bare knuckle into a brawl. If it ain't a fist, it ain't a fight.
Yeah!
Good, the fans are eating it up. And you spending all day fighting would rev up these punks.
Thank you, Sleazy Tarashi-san. To close it out, it's time for Bad Boy Aku-san to say a few words.
This one's a bit risky.
That was it? No way. He just stood there for this whole panel discussion? That's...
Heh.
Holy crap! Bad Boy Aku-san's the coolest! What a rebel! He doesn't play by the rules! Not even his own rules! That's what makes him Bad Boy Aku-san! He rules!
Good. It was the right decision to not let Quiet Aku speak after all. It doesn't take big talk to make a big man, and attitude speaks louder than words. I'd say that went pretty well.
Kiryu-san, were you watching?
Yeah, I saw everything. Good work.
Kiryu-san, we tried to apply what we learned from you about the ways of the Yankee to our panel. The fan response was fabulous. I'm still in shock.
Yeah, it seemed that way. You guys learned well. I'm proud of you all.
It looked like the Yokomichi Silvers will keep shooting up towards the stardom at the speed of light. We owe you big time, Kiryu-san.
You got the wild shirt.
Oh, that was the most fun I've ever had speaking in public.
Kiryu-san, thanks.
From now on, we're going to keep working hard to expand on what you taught us about the ways of the Yankee. We'll work hard on our speaking skills as well.
You and me both, buddy. You and me both.
Keep an eye on us, Kiryu-san. The Yokomichi Silvers are kicking it up another gear.
Yeah, give it your best shot.
We will.
People sure have all kinds of challenges to face. At least those guys are diligent. They should survive the rough road of the entertainment world, somehow. Don't give up, Yokomichi Silvers. That was a nice sub-story. Speaking of sub-stories, we also got one that's right over here. Something to do with a overseas star, perhaps? Oh, Kiryu-chan, ciao! I recognize that
mop of hair and the little bit of glasses that I saw. Hey, it's been a while. Are you still making shows that bring hopes and dreams to the people's lives? Ho ho ho! Easy for you to say, big Mr. Producer. Listen, I've got a chance here to drive viewers bananas, not just in Japan, but all over the world. How do you figure? You're a real producer after all, Kiryu-chan. A chance to whip the whole world into a frenzy got your attention? You know I'm just an amateur, but okay, I'm willing to listen to your fairy tale. What's going on to drive the world crazy?
Yeah.
The crazy thing is, it's no fairy tale at all.
Nani?
What? Heh. Is this enough of a hint for you? Woo! Jojo pose? You're making a Jojo movie?! You're the director of the new live-action Jojo film?!
Yeah.
What was that all about? Kiryu-chan, don't tell me you don't know who Miracle Johnson is. Miracle Johnson. I mean, please, continue. Miracle Johnson? Oh, I get it now. I just heard about him. He's some kind of sinner, right? Seriously? Kiryu, baby, are you telling me you hadn't heard of the pop star prince until today? He's world famous. Famous to the world, maybe, but this is Kamurocho, Japan. Why should that matter? Kamurocho is part of the world. Fine, it's not important. C'est la vie. Basically, Miracle is in Japan to shoot his new music video, but, and this is strictly hush-hush, there's been a little problemo holding up the El Shuto, you catch my drift? Yeah, you're saying there's a problem. Yes, and I'm convinced there's only one man capable of solving that problem. That's you, Kiryu-chan. I've been looking for you everywhere. I can't go into details because it's top secret mission, but will you help me? Let's see the world ablaze. Let's set the world ablaze, you and me. I love burning things. Fine. Let's hear it.
Whoa.
Now you're talking! That's what makes you an ace producer. So, what's the problem? It's the superstar himself, actually. Miracle's refusing to perform until his demands are met. We're at a standstill. What? Is the guy being a diva? Not really, no. He's just really insistent on doing the music video exactly right, and he won't compromise. What is this music video about? To be honest, I don't really get it. Apparently, it involves Miracle dancing his way through hordes of attacking zombies. I wonder what that's a reference to.
No.
Zombies? Yes, but if they were really to attack, it could get hurt, so we told the extras to take it easy when they swarm him. The Miracle got wind of that and blew his stack. He says the zombies have to attack like they mean it, otherwise the action wouldn't feel real. So he's refusing to do it? There's a lot I don't get here, like, how can a zombie video feel real to begin with? Who knows? These Westerners, man, they're so crazy. But this is gonna be a surefire hit if it happens. Well, I understand the problem now. What I don't get is how I fit into the picture. You're the man to keep the Miracle safe from the zombies, baby. You want me to protect him? Yeah, for the sake of realism, the zombies are gonna go all out to attack Miracle, to try and eat him and everything, but we can't let the pop star prince get hurt. That's where you come in, my old friend. Sounds like a strange gig, but it seems simple enough. Of course. Isn't it just the perfect job for you? Let's get to the deets and from the music video's director. Sure. I finally got the man for the job.
Oh, it's you, Pappy.
Sorry to keep you waiting. Introducing the powerhouse producer with the biggest brains, brawns, and balls in the modern mass media. Here's Kiryu-chan.
I'm Kazuma Kiryu. Good to meet you. Oh, so you're the famous Mr. Kiryu. I was told you have an extraordinary cool aura. I see it's true. I'm Mr. Spinning. the director. Welcome to our team, Mr. Kiryu. Oh, Mr. Kiryu, I should also introduce you to my PA, Luis. He's on the team too. Howdy, welcome to the family. Good to meet you. So, Kiryu-chan, is this blowing your mind or what? I'm sure you know already, but just in case. This man here is none other than the director of the massive worldwide smash hit movie Indiana Jeans. Oh my god, it is a Spielberg reference. Jesus Christ. I looked at his face and I was just like, is that supposed to be Spielberg? Oh my god. Indiana Jeans? Indian Jeans even? Oh my god. There's too many references right now. India, what? You're breaking my balls here, Kiryu-chan. Are you a hermit? How do you not know this man's films? Sorry. Are you supposed to be a reference as well? Mr. Kiryu, perhaps you're more of a sci-fi guy. Huh? Oh, right, Kiryu-chan. Even you have to know this one. A.T. You know, the one about the boy who rides with an alien on a unicycle over the moon. To be fair, that would have been a more entertaining movie than E.T. And E.T. was already an entertaining movie to begin with. Sure. I guess I might have heard about it. Yeah, see? I knew you had to know. Mr. Spinning is an amazing director, right, Kiryu-chan? Right?
そうだな.
Yeah. Amazing. It's no big deal, honestly. Though it was number one at the box office worldwide. Oh. It sure was. So, Mr. Spinning, with you at the helm of this music video, are we anticipating another worldwide hit?
そうですね.
Absolutely. The fans all over the world are waiting for this one. I don't want to waste any more time, but I need to confirm one thing before I describe your mission. Is that okay? Sure. We're here to film Miracle Johnson's latest music video. Do you understand what that means? Whole world's gonna be watching. Clever boy. But that's only half of it. The full answer is that it's gonna be the most exciting music video ever made. Failure to achieve that is unacceptable. Northfield's here. Yeah. Well, that's heavy. You have to hand it to Hollywood. They work on a scale we can only dream of. Don't you agree, Kiryu-chan? Yeah, it's huge. Also, if that's heavy, was that supposed to be a Back to the Future reference? Anyway. Whoa. Good. I'm glad you get the picture.
Hey!
Hey guys, Mr. Magic Johnson is ready to enter the room. Oh, good. Oh, Jesus Christ, man! The way your jaw moves is unnatural. Looks like Mr. Magic Johnson's about to join us. Let me introduce you to him. Hey, come on in! Miracle! Hey, Miracle. Looking rad as ever. You know it. Hey, hey. Spinning, I was born cool. Born to do it, yeah.
Hey, man.
Hey, man. You my partner? No. Kiryu-chan, what are you saying? Of course you're partners. Oh, that's right. I can't. No, I'm gonna get through this! Miracle, that's Mr. Kiryu, your partner today. He's a little shy.
Okay.
No problem. I heard about Japanese people being shy, so that's just human nature. It's all good! I'm Kiryu, glad to meet you. Woo! And I'm Miracle Johnson, nice to meet you! Yeah. Likewise.
Hey man,
have they told you about the mission, Mr. Kiryu?
Yeah.
A little, but I don't get it. I could use some more info. Okay, since you're all here, I'll explain what's happening. The setting is here. Kamurocho, one of Asia's, no, one of the world's premier entertainment districts.
Zombie hordes suddenly emerge and attack Miracle on the street. Miracle evades the attacking swarm and dances his way through the land of the rising sun, the very picture of cool. It's a tableau truly befitting of the pop star prince.
It's going to be a funky, yeah.
Woo! Woo! He's turning into Ric Flair!
Oi.
Hey, so why zombies? I still don't get what's going on. Apparently, they're really into that sort of thing overseas. I mean, if it's the big Hollywood director is behind it, it's gotta be a new trend. I think.
I think the city's fabulous! It always glitters and shines. I love it here, Kamurocho's like an amusement park!
Yes, and once the stage is set for a close encounter of the undead kind, Miracle will spin and weave his magic dance.
Hey.
Mr. Kiryu, this is where you come in. Your job is to escort Miracle and protect him from the walking dead.
I told the extras playing zombies to attack me like they mean it. If the danger's not real, the thrill isn't either.
I tried to stop him. If the pop star prince were injured on set, the whole world would be screaming for my head on a stake. That'd be really bad.
What? Who's bad?
God damn it, God damn it!
No, spinning. I told you how serious I am about this. Compromising my artistry would be a betrayal to all my loyal fans.
Miracle.
Oh.
You're the ultimate entertainer.
Yeah!
Oh. I'll stop spinning. That's... nothing the whole world doesn't already know!
I'm sorry about this, Kiryu-chan. I feel responsible.
Yeah.
No, it's alright. I know it's not your fault. So there you have it. Surely you understand now.
What part of that was understandable? Whatever. Let's just stop filming. I'm having trouble with this one. I'm having more trouble with this one than I did with the freaking Dominatrix sub-story.
Yeah, Kiryu, I light that fire. You're gonna rob my world with a passion like that?
That's enough. That's the spirit, Kiryu. Hold on to that anger and let's roll them.
We're going in! Woo!
Oh my god. I can't...
Nothing in Yakuza 5 or 4 came close to the craziness in this sub-story so far.
And I'm not even, like, a quarter of the way through them!
Miracle. And Kiryu, let me explain what you two have to do. Miracle, you unveil your new Miracle Award dance, shimmy and shake your way from here to the end of the street. I know you know this, but please try to keep it elegant.
Okay. No problem. This dance is gonna bedazzle the world!
So does Nick.
Mr. Kiryu, your job is to protect Miracle from the zombies by whatever means necessary. Got it.
Haha, good Kiryu! You're the man!
Samurai!
Why did you just say samurai?
Can we get on with this?
Yeah, please. Please, can we just... escort Miracle Johnson while he dances his way up Tenkaichi Street using his Miracle Walk technique. Along the way, zombies will appear and attack Miracle. You will fail if Miracle takes enough hits to bring his energy to zero. You succeed if Miracle reaches the Akoi Shimaru restaurant at the end of Tenkaichi Street before he runs out of energy. Okay, so it's like the sub-story with the bridge guy, except I can't fail. Oh my god. Okay. Gotta do this. Clothesline you. Oh my god, are you gonna moonwalk the whole way? Oh god, this is not going well. This is not going well. Okay, maybe Brawler style. Maybe Brawler style will be better. Actually, I'm gonna take this. Come at me, zombies. They are literally jumping from the rooftops. There we go. That works. Come at me, you fools. I have to say, though, I really like the music.
For people who haven't guessed already, this guy is an obvious reference to the pop star sensation Ozzy Osbourne. I mean, Michael Jackson. But I was not expecting a Spielberg reference. Is that... Did Spielberg, like, direct... What am I trying to say? The music video? I don't think that's a thing. I think they just put Spielberg in there because he's a reference to... 80s pop culture? I honest to God, don't know. I'm not very big when it comes to music, so it's not something that I usually know about. No, 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 no! Don't you dare! Okay. Let me pick up this bike. This seems to be a very, very effective strategy. We're like two-thirds of the way there. I can do this. Just need to protect him for a bit longer. Alright, come at me, you zombies! Although, last time I checked, this music video was in a cemetery, but whatever. Oh my god. No, don't you dare! Shit. No. No. Damn it. Can't lose now. We're almost there. Can't you moonwalk any faster? I know it's like a really unique technique that only you know, but still. I mean, other people know it, but you invented it, I guess, technically. Whatever.
Oh.
Excellent. Amazing. Magnificent. That was a stupendous miracle. I can tell you right now that I just shot the greatest music video of all time. This would be the stuff of legend. I mean, Take On Me had a pretty good music video, you know, I'm just saying.
Spin him, please. I only did what was expected of me. The real honor goes to Kiryu. He was cooler than us. Too cool!
You are so right. Kiryu, if it weren't for you, this masterpiece would never have happened. From the bottom of my heart, I thank you. No need to thanks. Beating down hostile guys seems to be part of my daily routine.
Hey, man.
Hey, Kiryu. How would you like to be my personal bodyguard? You would like... be like another part of me, man.
Kiryu, baby. This is it, man. The golden ticket. The pop star princess recruiting you. Babysitting a superstar might be a decent life, but the world is too big for a stage for me. Kamurocho is plenty big.
Oh, how disappointing. But I guess I can't deprive Kamurocho of his star. That's the way you make me feel, Kiryu.
Kiryu-chan.
Very well, I'll leave you with a gift then. Hey zombies, come on!
Black or white?
Black or white? Just tell me!
A large black box and a small white box. Black or white? Which should I pick? Oh my god. I get it. It don't matter if you're black or white. I'm gonna go for the smaller one. I honest to God don't know what's in each of them, but let's go for it. White.
Okay, what it is? My gift to you.
This. What is this? You got a baseball shirt.
Isn't it delightful?
Sure. Gratefully accepted.
Thank you, Kiryu. You're going to be the Kamurocho King, I can tell. After all, I'm the pop star prince of the world. Woo!
Hey. I still don't really get you your American groove, but it was a thrilling experience all the same. At least, I'll never have to fight zombies again.
And if I'm ever back in Japan, I'm gonna look you up, Kiryu. You wouldn't mind, would you?
I'll think about it.
Hey,
Miracle. You better get going. The world needs to see what we've got waiting for them.
Looks like my time is up. I'll see you around, Kiryu. I got a feeling this isn't the last time.
Sure. I look forward to it. Oh my god, what an adventure. An adventure that was literally just walking down a street. Only in Kamurocho and Yakuza. Miracle Johnson thinks we'll meet again. Heh, maybe we will. Well, folks, I'm pretty sure you've guessed already, but it's going to be the end of the episode right there. I don't think I could take another sub-story right now. I'm going to have to recuperate a little bit. So, remember to like, comment, share, subscribe, all of that fun jazz, and I'll see you guys next time.